historic week compared to when we see other teams. Do the fans expect to go along there? I mean, South Korea, Turkey, they were at the same World Cup actually, weren't they? I think in the top two in 2002.
See, Nicola Lyon has
South Korea was something extraordinary, and I remember very well, because that was just seven matches, and I was there commentating on six of them. And I mean, it blew your mind what they did there. And also, coupled with that, was everything that surrounded what South Korea did in that country. I think more widely, it feels like there have been sporadic occasions. I mean, there was that
The relationship between France and Morocco, but in 2022,
this is a very significant game. Both for
French people and Moroccans in France.
After the relationship between the two countries, as I mentioned, the protectorate, Morocco was a protected country by France.
Dry and sunny first thing, you see those very similar, and you kind of see the response between
the countries. France is still the main partner economically from Morocco, even if there's less, I think Morocco is not coming over like they did in the 50s or even in the 70s,
but you still have millions of people in France from Friday is Saturday, mostly dry and sunshine. There's a big change, much milder conditions by the time we get to Monday. That's 4 degrees tomorrow, I'm going to celebrate.
This is a very emotional night, it's a very special game, and millions of people both in France and in Morocco will feel the same. We'll have relatives in one or the other country, we'll be born in one of them, and we've got comedians, Jamel Debbouze and Gaden Malek, for example, who have the two nationalities as well. So I want people in the UK to really understand how the two countries change and how much this means, even more for Moroccans, because they don't see this as a revenge.
I'll flip between them both.
But it's more like, I think for a long time they wanted their voice to be heard maybe a bit more. But I think tonight this is the opportunity, and we saw in the quarterfinals that the Champs-Élysées was full of Moroccans with the flies and the shirt and the partying and everything. It went a little bit too far, but let's hope tonight if they win, and even if they don't win, it would be celebrated the way it should, because we haven't had a game between the two countries since 2007. Because it's always a bit tense if they meet in Paris or if they meet in Casablanca, for example.
And frighteningly, there will be politicians, particularly on the right, who are waiting to capitalise on any misbehaviour. With their very simple message, as I understand it, Brad, well, they're not really. If they're celebrating Morocco winning, they're not friends. Which is just, well, A, disgusting, and B, ridiculous.
Yeah, completely. I mean, I don't even want to mention the one politician who is the most vocal about that. We need to be ashamed of them, so it's more as one of them, even more than Marine Le Pen, by the way. He was a talk show about, well, if they don't support France, they should not live in that country, which, like you said, is disgusting and unacceptable, really, but I think this goes...